Excited.
Yeah. No, it's great. It's a lot of fun. It's a great opportunity. And I told the young guys at a walkthrough, just have fun. A lot of guys are going to have a great opportunity first time, make a start for the first time. I've been fortunate to start quite a few. Cut it loose and just go play ball.
Wayne, if you have to play in the playoffs, if you're needed then, like how much will this help have, get some work?
You know, it's a great dry run. Ultimately, the reason we play football is to play in the games, right? And it's a great opportunity not only for myself, but a lot of guys to maybe play in different positions that they have been throughout the year. Justin Ross, KT, it's a new system, right? So you're always working through things, and the installs are new every week, and it's just about how you prepare throughout the week, kind of week in and week out, because the game plans do change every week. And you know, the more or longer you're in a system, the more comfortable you are. So you know, it's been called 20-25 weeks including the summer in this system, so it's going really well.
You mentioned the guys like Justin Ross and KT, and you know, more beneficial is it to you to have guys you work with all year round?
Yeah, it's fun when you go out there and actually play meaningful football with guys that, like you said, you've gotten reps with on scout team, and now it's just kind of taking the work from the practice to the game. And just like I said, go out, play fast, have fun. And those guys are phenomenal athletes. They've all played a lot of high level football, and there's a lot of talent that they all have.
That's
the
most intriguing.
Mm-hmm.
We haven't got
look back, he hasn't played that much football since his freshman year of college, but the amount of athletic ability that he has is extremely rare. I've been around the game for a long time, and seeing what he can do in and out of cuts, catching the football, making plays, it's fun to watch. So just getting these reps throughout the week in practice and the game is going to be extremely valuable for him as kind of his career progresses.
What changes have you seen in the Chargers defensively since you played them a few weeks ago?
You know, it just depends. They're playing a little more split safety zone. They're playing fast. They're playing hard. And, you know, when I've been on teams where coaching staffs change mid-year, right? And so a lot of the coaches, a lot of these players are playing not only for their jobs, but for their resume for next year, right? So this team's not going to lay down. They're playing extremely hard. They played Denver tough last week, and they're going.
Well, this goes back several weeks, but when Patrick in Denver was not feeling well and wasn't at the top of his game, how close do you think you were to entering that game?
You know, I think as a starter, there's a lot of pride at being a starter, right? You never want to come out of a game. And, you know, he was a little under the weather, and I was too. I think I was probably the one that gave it to him. But, you know, so we were both kind of battling there in Denver, not feeling good. It was cold. And, yeah, that was a tough one.
Blaine, you've been around a league a long time, man. Of course, you know about guys that need, at the end of the season, they have personal goals, want to get their statistical in those categories. How much are these guys in your ear?
The culture that we have here, there's a lot of selfless individuals. I know you're getting a Travi 16 yards away from 1,000. Right. We all know that. Okay. But, you know, that's he wants team success first, and he's always been that way. He genuinely loves football, and you know, if he wants to play, he'll play. And if he's Coach Reed's decision to have him rest, he's going to rest. And ultimately, that's on Coach Reed. But, you know, if we're out there, we're going to do our damn best to get him 17 yards.
Well, what would it mean to you, Blaine, if you are able to do that for him?
You know, it'd be a lot of fun. I think he's got a big string of 1,000-yard seasons in a row. So
this would be 8 in a row.
And no tight ends come even close to that. And
correct, right.
Now you're getting into the receiver talk. You're the Mike Evans of the world, who's done 10 or 11 straight now this year. And that's a rare, special group of individuals, Hall of Fame individuals, to kind of have that run in a row. So he may say it doesn't mean anything, but it means something for the quarterback and for this organization to get him that 1,000 yards.
You mentioned Travis. Rasheed's another guy. Mm-hmm. He wants to get there, I'm sure.
Yeah, and just kind of the way Rasheed's taken off this last half of the year is awesome. And that's a credit to this coaching staff preparing him to be ready to play 17 games, because it's a long season in the NFL. Coming from college, it's 12 games. So a lot of those guys you see hit a rookie wall and start fading in the second half of the year. But he's done a great job and really kind of caught his stride here going to the playoffs.
Blaine, big picture quarterback question.
So Tom Brady, I think you think you're friends with him.
Yes.
He talked about how rage and anger helped him. Like, he talked about, like, how those emotions were good. Mm-hmm. And I was curious, in your career quarterbacking and being around great quarterbacks, like, how you think about those specific emotions, the rage and anger, and how it might mm-hmm. clarify some people's game.
Well, I think rage and anger, if you can bottle that up, if you can harness the emotion and channel it positively, you know, that's the best thing. And Tom always said, he's like, I have no friends on the opposing team. And it held true. I mean, he genuinely did not like the opposing team. Now, after the game, he may shake their hands if we win. He genuinely, that's how he played the game. And he played the game at a damn high level for 22, 23 years. And that worked for him. Now, every person, every personality, every human being is different. How they get themselves ready to play, how they prepare throughout the week. And like you said, rage and anger fit him well because he knew how to channel that and bottle that up and played the best football ever for 2 decades. So everybody's different, but, you know, he channeled that pretty well.
Like, not that you're going to give us your game plan, but will this be using your strengths? I mean, is this a game where, you know, you're going to use the things that have worked for you and maybe a little different than what, you know, would be if Patrick were starting?
Yeah, it's a great question. And we had to talk with the coaching staff. There's a system in place here. We run Coach Reed's offense. And ultimately, that's what we are going to run. Now, every quarterback is different. Every quarterback does things differently. Some things better than others, et cetera, et cetera. And we're just going to run our offense. Hopefully throw to the open guy, run the ball well, and score some points.
Do you throw the ball different? Guys have dropped passes when they've been tight spirals coming at them 500 miles an hour.
You know, every quarterback throws the ball differently, and there's a lot of things that go into whether a pass is completed or not. And, you know, it may look very easy to an outsider looking in, but there's a lot of things that kind of go into it. Windows, tight coverage, hands getting knocked down. So, you know, our receivers are going to do a great job this week, and I have full confidence in them.
Blaine, you mentioned running Andy Reid's offense. Does that mean no quarterback sneaks?
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe maybe do the little tush push or something, but hope not.
All right, guys.
Thanks, man.
Thanks, Blaine. Good to see you.
You too, Mike.